Islamic approach to combating AIDS experience from Uganda. Background: the Islamic Medical Association of Uganda has been involved in combating HIV/AIDS using the Islamic approach since 1989, September 23, during its 10th convention. Also, the Islamic approach to combating reviewed the progress achieved so far and made strategic plans to chart the way forward. And the Islamic approach to combating set itself the following mission to reflect its calling in the fight against AIDS: to contribute to the national and international response to HIV/AIDS guided by Islamic teachings and scientific knowledge. The Islamic approach to combating AIDS vision with regards to combating AIDS is as follows. The Islamic approach was reviewed. Excellence in fighting for an HIV/AIDS free community using the Islamic approach. The Islamic approach was reviewed during the convention and its defining as consisting of the following components: 1. Education on the scientific knowledge about AIDS. 2. Promoting and using Islamic teachings and practices which encourage AIDS prevention and control. 3. Using the Islamic administrative sector with the mosque and its imam as the major pillar to deliver AIDS education and counseling to the grassroots communities. 4. Promoting the jihad nafs in combating AIDS, which means the struggle by each individual to prevent AIDS and care for those infected and affected. These ideas will be further clarified in this article. Scientific knowledge update on AIDS. Seeking for knowledge is a basic requirement of the Islamic approach to HIV/AIDS. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was reported as saying, "Seeking for knowledge is compulsory upon every Muslim, male or female." Epidemiology. The AIDS epidemic is still ravaging the world. The Joint United Nations Program on AIDS estimated that 3.1 million people died of AIDS in 22. 5 million people acquired the infection in the same year, bringing the total number of people living with HIV/AIDS to 42 million globally. This figure is an increase from that of the year 21, where the total number of adults and children living with HIV/AIDS was 40 million. Sub-Saharan Africa has the largest population of people living with AIDS, numbering 29 million. It is followed by South and Southeast Asia with 6 million people living with HIV/AIDS. North Africa and the Middle East have 500,000 people with HIV/AIDS. All these regions have significant Muslim populations who are likely to be infected or affected by HIV/AIDS. HIV transmission. The main route of HIV transmission is sexual intercourse, which accounts for 70-80% of cases globally. The sexual intercourse is mostly heterosexual, vaginal in the majority of cases, 60-70%, but it may be homosexual, and in 5-10% of cases, HIV transmission from mother to child is the second commonest route, accounting for 5-10% of cases. This may occur in utero at birth and during breastfeeding, injecting a drug, and through sharing needles is another important cause, accounting for 5-10% of cases globally. HIV infection can also be acquired through blood transfusion, accounting for 3-5% of cases. Organ and tissue donations such as semen, kidney, and cornea donations may occasionally transmit HIV infection. Contaminated skin, piercing instruments can also transmit HIV infection. Healthcare workers can be infected through needle stick injury, but this is rare. The transmission from A percutaneous exposure to an HIV positive patient is 0.32%. Natural history and clinical features. On average, if an adult person acquires HIV infection and gets no antiretroviral therapy, it takes 10 to 11 years from the time of HIV transmission to the time of death. The natural history is faster in children, where 75% die before 5 years of age. The course of HIV infection is divided into the following stages. Stage 1, primary in HIV infection. This is the stage when antibodies to HIV infection are forming. It lasts 3 months. On average, some patients, 25% to 65%, may have symptoms such as fever, malaise, headache, and joint pain. Stage 2, symptomatic phase. This stage lasts about 8 to 10 years on average, but it may be longer or shorter in some people. The patient has antibodies to HIV infection, but no symptoms. Stage 3, persistent generalized lymphadenopathy. Some patients have enlarged lymph nodes, but with no other symptoms. This usually occurs during the symptomatic stage of HIV infection. Stage 4, symptomatic HIV infection. This lasts 1 to 3 years on average, but maybe longer. Virtually any organ in the body may be involved. The major manifestations are due to opportunistic infections or tumors. The patient may have constitutional symptoms of fever lasting at least 1 month and weight loss of greater than 10% of the normal baseline weight. Over symptoms and sign depends on the organ and system affected, as given in the following example. Skin. Skin infections may be fungal, such as crudous bacteria, such as impetigo, and or viral, such as herpes zoster and Molluscum contagiosum, and may